In this video, I will show you how to allow only numbers that do not exceed a total sum in Excel like this. So let's get started. Here in this Excel sheet, I have two columns, one for the product name and another for the quantity to order. Now I want to create a validation that will only allow quantity numbers such that the total sum of all product quantities does not exceed the maximum quantity of 100 given in this column. To do that, I will use the Excel sum function. The sum function adds individual numbers, cell references, cell ranges, or arrays. For example, this sum formula will return the total of all three cell values in the range B3 to B5. I will add all the product quantities and then compare the sum with the maximum allowed total quantity value to check if the sum exceeds the total. Let's create a validation rule based on this. Select all the quantity cells, go to the data tab and click the data validation icon to open the data validation dialog box. Since we are going to create a custom rule, select the custom option from the allow drop-down menu. Let's start the formula by typing an equal sign in the formula text box. Now we need to enter our validation formula, which will return either a true or false value depending on the cell value. I will enter this formula which adds the quantity in the C3 to C6 cell range using the sum function and then compare it with the total allowed quantity value given in the E3 column. I will also make the cell references absolute using the dollar signs like this so that they do not change when Excel applies this formula to other cells in the range. Click the OK button to close the dialog box. Now, when I enter any quantity value where the total sum of the quantity does not exceed 100, it works fine. But if I enter a quantity value that causes the total quantity value to exceed the maximum allowed quantity of 100, Excel will display an error message. This value doesn't match the data validation restrictions defined for this cell. I can press the retry button to edit the quantity or the cancel button to clear the entered value. We can also change the title and message of the error dialog box to make it clearer to users. To do that, select all the quantity cells again, click on the data menu, and then click the data validation icon. Now click on the error alert option at the top of the dialog box. Make sure that the show error alert after invalid data is entered checkbox is selected. I will type the invalid quantity text is the title and the total quantity must not exceed 100 text as the error message. Click the OK button to close the dialog box. Now, when we try to enter an invalid quantity value in any of these cells, we will get the error dialog box with our custom title and message. To remove this validation from the quantity cells, select all the cells and then click the data validation icon again. Now click the clear all button to reset all the validation values we entered previously. Click the OK button to close the dialog box. Now these cells do not have any validation restriction and we can enter any quantity we want. Watch these videos for more Excel tips, tricks and how-to tutorials. If you find this video useful, please like the video and subscribe to our channel.